Semoga.
Di tempat mem resmi banyak ABK juga ya, Bu?
Ada Pak, ada 8, ada 8 saya Pak.
Kalau
Karena kita kan tidak boleh menolak.
saya banyak, Bu. Setiap kelasnya itu ada dua. Jadi ada sekitar 14, belum yang kelas 11-nya.
Ya.
Ada
Dulunya
25, Bu.
banyak ya.
Umar.
Umar sakit, oh, di BK Pak. Di BK sedang sakit.
Oh, di BK.
Iya, dibantu ya Pak kalau
cuman kita
ada
nggak
teman
tiap
sakit.
kali
Iya, di dari rumah
mau
sudah
buat
pusing
fokus
kayaknya
ya
jadi
untuk
pingsan.
menangani anak ABK itu kita nggak paham benar gitu.
ABK-nya modelnya gimana bagaimana aja Bu Rusmi? Yang
Gimana Pak?
slow learner, model
Yang slow
ABK-nya
slow respon.
slow respon
Macam-macam Pak.
macam-macam.
Ada yang
Ya, yang
autis,
Bu Rusmi, misalnya Bu Rusmi.
ada yang autis, ada yang hanya slow respon,
Slow,
ada yang
paling banyak
benar-benar.
prinsipnya slow respon, Bu.
Ada
Malah.
satu yang sudah seperti apa ya? Lebih
Down syndrome.
mengarahnya ke
Down
benar-benar
syndrome.
ABK, ada
Iya. Down
satu orang.
syndrome.
Ya.
Tempat di sini ada yang memasuk tempat saya ada yang ini yang tuna tuna apa yang buta bener tuh. Ada
Oh.
tuh nggak jadi tapi
Tapi kalau
pernah
di
kalah.
sini nyambung Pak, nulis gitu nyambung, hanya slow respon, ada dua ya. Yang benar-benar nulis nggak nyambung, slow respon, terus dari pandangannya juga sudah aneh itu satu, ada satu.
Kalau yang benar-benar nggak bisa lihat, bingung ngajarnya. Mengajar
Jadi,
apaan, dia nggak bisa huruf braille juga nggak bisa.
ya suka aneh-aneh gitu Pak, bertindak yang aneh-aneh itu
Oh iya, itu ada
only
juga di
one.
sini. Di
Nah,
sini
only
ada.
one.
Itu apa namanya tuh? Dia hidup dengan dunianya sendiri, nyaman dengan dunianya.
Ya, terus suka teriak-teriak di sendiri.
Oh ada. Jadi
Ya.
kalau apa ya, kalau diganggu sama temannya.
Kalau diganggu agresif, Pak, lebih ini
Iya,
lagi lebih
betul.
galak gitu. Kalau jelas dia
Makanya repot
mukul.
menangani yang kayak gitu.
Ya.
Harusnya sih enggak.
Alhamdulillah yang begitu cuma satu, Pak, tapi
Di sini mah
kadang-kadang juga
ada
kurang sopan sama guru
14
gitu.
di sini, Bu. Macam-macam kayak gitu. Jadi dia numpang numpang duduk aja di kelas. Dia
Harus
mau
naik kelas
ngapain?
lagi ya Pak,
Ya, dia mau
nilainya harus
ngerjain
ada
apa
ya.
dia nggak mau. Disuruh ngerjain apa-apa nggak mau.
Sementara nilai di bawah KKM nggak boleh Pak.
Nggak boleh. Ya, jadi waktu PJJ itu ternyata yang ngejawab itu orang tuanya.
Ya, kalau enggak guru lesnya Pak, kalau di sini ada
Yang kuliahnya
mereka
nggak mau.
ya setelah ditanya ada guru lesnya yang menjawab.
Kasihan sih sebenarnya kalau di sekolah umum dia orang ABK itu. Harusnya ada penanganan khusus.
Ya,
Jadi
Pak,
potensinya bisa dimaksimalkan kalau di sekolah khusus.
ada SLB tapi malah kenapa dimasukkan ke negeri ya, Pak? Kok juga
Iya, kenapa nggak SLB-nya
tahu.
diperbanyak gitu?
Mbak, SLB
SLB-nya
juga
ditambah.
kosong banyak, Pak. SLB itu
Dananya
banyak yang
habis, Bu.
kosong.
Dananya habis, Bu.
Dananya. Oh.
Ya itu pasti kalau kalau sampai SLB apa anak-anak ABK itu masuknya ke sekolah umum, berarti kan dananya habis.
Iya.
Oh my God. Jatuh.
Repot juga ya. Repot bener.
PR Pak, homework.
Jadi tempat penitipan anak aja itu, sekolah umum. Tempat penitipan anak. Anak ya kayak gitu, anak yang bermasalah.
But when the teacher can excuse upon this student, ya enggak Pak? Enggak
Aduh,
boleh.
Masya Allah.
Pokoknya no excuse.
No excuse.
Excuse.
Yeah.
Boleh. Saya kalau jam pertama itu selalu kosong, Pak. Alhamdulillah, jam pertama kedua selalu kosong sampai pukul 8.10. Tapi kesininya berderet. Two, three, four, until nine.
Saya alhamdulillah Bu Rusmi di PPG ini dapat jamnya jam-jam terakhir Bu. Jadi ngikutin kuliah sampai selesai ya nggak masalah.
Enak tuh Pak bisa.
Iya Pak. Ngajar-ngajar udah di atas jam setengah 12.
Benar-benar. Kawan kita baru berapa orang? still having a breakfast.
Belum datang, Desmi belum join. Desmi, terus Herlina,
Febi.
Febi udah ada.
Ila Holila.
Ila belum juga Ila.
Pak Ildes sama Pak Bisa, saya sebentar ya, yeah. Ada izin ke belakang sebentar.
Ya, yeah. Oke. Okay,
Mr. Biso, Mr. Hildes, yes. And the rest of you guys, we are going to wait for the rest of the participant first, and then, like usual, we are going to start the session at 7:50.
Okay,
Mr. Biso. Okay, sir. You okay, may sir. Grab some coffee or getting your breakfast or do anything, that's okay. At 7:50, okay. We are going to start the session.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay.
Jam terakhir terus. Oh, jam 7, 8, 9, 10. Udah. Enak jadi beratnya. Ngikutin kuliah. Nggak terganggu.
Maybe you can try to contact Miss Herlina, Mr. B.
Yes,
Yeah,
sir.
so she can join at 7:50. Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Mr. Sofian, I'm Rizmi. Sorry, I'm a little bit late.
Yeah, morning, Miss April. It's okay. We start on 7:50, ma'am.
morning, Nikila. Morning, Mr. Biso.
Morning, Miss Nibi. How are you today, Miss Nibi?
Great, sir. I'm fine. How about you?
Very well, thank you. Miss Nibi, you are wearing white shirt, yeah? Every
Wednesday. Yeah, that's my uniform here. Every Wednesday, yeah, to wear white shirt and pink or scarf for women.
And black skirt?
Yes, black skirt.
Oh, P3 ka? No.
No, PNS.
Oh.
Yeah, P3 ka also have to wear, not every day, right? They have to wear
white
shirt and black skirt every day. Yeah, but the scarf is for women. So for women, the color should be different. For men, I think there will be no different than every Wednesday.
Yeah. But the civil servant here are wearing pramuka.
Pramuka, yeah.
Yeah.
Not in here in Banten. You have to wear white and
different,
black.
Different way to wear the uniform. Okay, Mr. Sofyan?
Okay, it is already 7:50 and then all of the participants already joined.
Only one, Mr. Sofyan. Mr. Herlina is giving some assignment for 2,200 students.
Okay, 2,200 students, well, that's amazing. Okay, come on, Mr. B, you will lead us to open our session for today.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Sofyan. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, Mr. Sofyan, Mrs. Rusmi, and my friends in PP Geldal Job Breakout Room 1. Yeah, let's start our session for today by the first praying as usual. Yeah, and I want Miss Indri. Miss Indri, would you help us to lead for the prayer, Miss Indri?
Okay, sir. Can you hear my voice? Because I'm in teacher's room, maybe a little bit noisy.
Clear. Okay,
thank you, Mr. B, for the time. Okay, I'm sorry if it's noisy here. Okay, good morning, members me and Mr. Sofyan and all my friends here. So before we start our activity for today, let me pray together. Let's hope that all of our PP Geldalja process will go smoothly and all of us will lulus with flying colors. Okay, so let's we pray based on our religion. Pray, begin.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Okay, pray ends. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, thank you, Miss Indri. And for the PP Geldalja Indonesia greeting, Miss Ila. Is there Miss Ila?
Yes, sir. I'm here.
Would you please lead us for the PP Geldalja?
Okay.
Greeting.
Well, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Dear Mr. Sofyan, Mrs. Rusmi, and all my PP Geldalja friends, please start our activity today by doing PP salam PPG Indonesia. Would you please stand up?
Okay.
Well, and please unmute yourself, everyone.
Okay.
Okay, are you ready?
Ready.
Okay, Mr. Okay. Hildes, Miss April, Miss Dwi, Mr. Five. Mr. B, let's do salam PPG Indonesia.
Salam PPG.
PPG Indonesia.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Salam. Sapa.
Sapa.
Selamat.
Selamat.
Sukses.
Surga.
Surga. Amin. Thank you very much.
Welcome.
Welcome.
Thank you very much, Miss Ila Holila. Okay, now for the ice breaking, I'm doing myself, yeah, for you. Okay, my friends in big room one, PPG Deljab, let's talk about our wish. Yeah, you know, when I have been in Tainan Channel High School, my school is next to the big apartment, yeah, my friend. And when the first time I came to this building, yeah, and I have got the 11th grade, yeah, in the fourth floor, at the time when I take a look, when I took a look to the side, yeah, of the apartment, there is, yeah, there was, and now there has been, sorry, there has been a big swimming pool. When I had a look, wow, swimming pool. And I, in my mind, I had a wish. If I were rich, I would have a house with my private swimming pool. I could rest in the afternoon or in the weekend by swimming and then playing around in the in my swimming pool at the backyard. Okay, now I want you to make your wish when you had something not done by yourself in a long time ago from Mr. Five Fabry. What would you do if you were rich, Mr. Five Fabry?
If I rich, I will buy football club.
Football club. Wow. Football club. You would have a football club, Mr. Fabri.
Real Madrid.
Yeah. Wow, Real Madrid.
Biar bisa beli Zizou.
Zizou. Oh. Okay, Miss Ila Holila, what would you do if you were rich?
If I were rich, I would go with my parents to Mekah. As soon as possible.
Haji.
Yes.
And Umrah. Umrah. That's nice.
Thank
okay,
you.
Now, Miss Feby. What would you do, Miss Feby, if you were rich?
I were rich. I would travel around the world, sir.
Travel around the world. Okay.
Yes.
Miss Desmi, what would you do, Miss Desmi, if you were rich?
If I were rich, I will build some house.
Some house.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you, Miss Indri. What would you do if you were rich, Miss Indri? Miss Indri.
Oh yeah, I'm sorry, sir. I have unstable connection here. Okay, if I were rich, I would visit all the countries in the world.
Not clear, Miss Indri.
Can you hear my voice? Hello.
Not clear, Miss Indri.
Yeah, because I have unstable connections
sir. Wait. I'm going to check my. Hello. Good.
Okay. Now, Miss Endang, what would you do if you were rich?
I will bring my father to Mecca like Miss Ila, and then I will build a halfway house for broken home child.
Oh my, that's nice. Yeah.
Inshallah.
Miss April, what would you do if you were rich?
I will go around the world, my family, and buy anything I want.
Okay, thank you. Miss Kartika, what would you do if you were rich, Miss Kartika?
If I were rich, I want to go to Mecca with my family like Miss Ila, and I want to build some house to rent with someone who need that so that I can get the money again.
Yeah, okay, Mr. Hildes, what would you do, Mr. Hildes, if you were rich?
If I were rich, I would ask you all of you to Mecca, guys.
Wow. Thank you. Miss Diana, what would you do, Miss Diana, if you were rich?
Okay. If I rich, I will borrow my family to Mecca, same with Miss Kartika, and I want to buy a private plane to trip around in the world.
Around the world. Private plane.
Yes.
Okay, the last one, Miss Herlina, are you joining us?
Yes.
Okay, Miss Herlina, what would you do if you were rich, Miss Herlina?
If I were rich, I would go to Mecca first, and then I would go around the world, of course.
And, okay.
And everything I could buy, I buy it. That's it.
Okay, Mr. Sofyan.
Thank you.
Time back to you.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Biso Arno. That was a beautiful, that was British kind of dreams, yeah. And then I guess that's some kind of general dreams that you guys had. Yeah, there are no such kind of a wild one. Mr. Biso Arno asks you if you guys preach. You can do anything, right? Not only to bring your family, not only to bring your blah blah blah. A simple one. I'll be the king of the world. That should be everything, yeah. You'll be the princess of the world, I guess. Yeah, that should be the dreams, okay? Out of the box, yeah. Okay, we are going to start our today's session. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. Wabihi nasta'in wa la umurin dunia wa din. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'ad. Our respected honorable here, Miss Rusmi, as our senior teacher, and then all our beloved students from the first group of PPG Dalje batch 1. How are you guys today?
Very well, Mr. Sabian.
Okay, it's only Mr. B that answering, and then the rest of you may guys still teaching your student then. Okay, I hope you guys will be ready for the first day in discussing about your guys' action planning. Yeah, what kind of the planning that you're going to do, that you're going to make. So it will be the basic for you to do the peer teaching, and then also for the teaching practice. Yeah, for our today's sessions, I'm gonna divide it into two sessions. Yeah, the first session, Ms. Rusmi gonna lead you guys here to discuss all the things about K-13 curriculum. Yeah, K-13 curriculum, yeah, the lesson plan, and then learning media, learning material, student worksheet, and then assessment instrument. Yeah, and then after that one, the second session, you guys will be with me. We are going to discuss about freedom to learn curriculum, yeah, and then learning module, yeah. When I have the training for all teacher in Jakarta, Central Jakarta, East Jakarta, and then all Jakarta, we need 5 days to conduct an explanation, a comprehensive one about freedom to learn curriculum, and then also learning module. And then you guys gonna have it only 1 hour. So you don't have to expect too much, yeah. At least we are going to discuss about the freedom to learn curriculum and then the details of it, and then also the example of learning module. Okay, guys. Now let's try to have a look at the PowerPoint first, based on the second subject. Okay, you guys can see my PowerPoint here.
Yep.
Okay, now let's try to have a look at the page that you guys already made. Yeah, all of you guys already conducted the problem identifications. Yeah, you guys already chose the problem. Yeah, on the first subject of PPGD algebra, and then second one here for the second. Making a learning an innovative kind of teaching and learning for the students, you guys also already created these solutions. Yeah, so the step 4 and then step 5, you already guys made it. Yeah, and then our focus for the rest of the second subject here, we are going to talk about the making of action planning, and then making the plan for the evaluations. Yeah, and then now let's try to have a look at what is it. Okay, here you guys can see exploring the alternative solution 3 days, and then providing the solution 3 days, and then we are going to have 6 days here to talk and then to discuss about what kind of the action plan that you are going to do, and then 2 days to arrange the evaluation planning. Okay, now let's try to have a look at the meeting that we are going to have today here. It will be on, wait a second, 19 to 24. Yeah, okay, now we can have a look at here from your guys' activities, the designing of an innovative learning based on the root of the problem, cause root of the problem, and then have a tactic solution that you guys have reformulated, and then it should be about problem-based learning and then project-based learning. And then the second one, it will be the same, arranging lesson plan, and then all of the learning tools that we are going to use based on PBL and then PJBL, problem-based and then also project-based learning. And then consists of several things, a set of learning here, a set of teaching and learning that you're going to create consists of the first, it will be RPP, and then second one, learning material, the third one, it will be learning media, the fourth one, it will be student worksheet, and then last one, it will be about the assessment instrument that you are going to use. And then all of this detail here, specifically for this school that's still using K-13 curriculum, okay, but for this school that using a freedom to learn curriculum or curriculum merdeka kumer, you are going to make only what we call by learning module. Yeah, because in a learning module consists all of the details here. Yeah, that's the difference between K-13 curriculum and then the freedom to learn curriculum. Okay, and then next one, the third one here, you're going to learn, you're going to arrange the lesson plan. You have to notice when I mention about lesson plan, and then it is also referred to the learning module that you are going to use, yeah, as the basis when you guys arrange the lesson plan and then learning module. And then after that one, we are going to make all of the tools, all of the learning design based on the offline and then also online learning. So you guys are gonna have the experience in conducting the teaching and learning using an online one or even using an offline one. Yeah, and then next one, you're going to get the discussion with the lecturer and also senior teacher in getting the description and then the same perceptions about how that you are going to arrange the lesson plan or learning module that based on problem-based learning and then also project-based learning. And we can have a look at here the tasks, your guys' learning design here, your guys' setup learning design, yeah. An innovative one consists of two action planning, yeah. And then each of the action planning consists of two meetings. So we are going to have four meetings, yeah. Four meetings that you are going to create the innovative kind of teaching and learning for your students, yeah. Since consists of two action planning. And then here is the scoring rubric for this one. Yeah, you guys may read it by yourself, I guess. I'm not gonna mention it, but this, the difference between the previous scoring rubric here, the maximum point, it will be 5. If the previous one consists of 4 as the maximum point, for this one, it is 5, yeah, the maximum point. Okay, and then we can have a look at the learning media, the instrument that you guys use, yeah. Okay, the learning material, the student worksheet, yeah. It will be the same, the first action planning and then also the second action planning. Okay, that will be our focus in 6 days starting from today, yeah. We are going to discuss more what is it, the concept of lesson plan in a K-13 curriculum, yeah. Inshallah will be explained by Miss Rusmi after this one, and then also the example of lesson plan in K-13 curriculum, how did you guys arrange the lesson plan in K-13 curriculum, yeah. And then after that one also you're going to get the, what is it, the insight about what is it, the element that you guys have to consider while we talk about K-13 curriculum, especially when we make the lesson plan, when we make the learning material, and then also the learning media, and then the student worksheet, and then last one, the assessment instruments. And then the next session, it will be with me. We are going to discuss more, yeah, 1 hour or 1.5 hours. Here we are going to discuss our freedom to learn curriculum specifically to the learning module. And then what kind of learning module that you are going to use if your school here is consists of, are you still using or using the new curriculum here, freedom to learn curriculum. And then for the rest of you that still using K-13 curriculum, still you guys have to master at least the basic thing about what we call by the freedom to learn curriculum, and then what is it, the learning module, and then what is it, the learning outcomes, yeah. And then there are many terms that related with the freedom to learn curriculum, yeah. Okay, I guess that will be the opening before we're gonna go with Miss Rusmi to enlighten us here with the example or with the explanation about the K-13 curriculum, and then after that one the lesson plan, and then after that one the learning media, and then the student worksheet, assessment instrument, and then also the learning media. I hope you guys gonna have the, what is it, the question first. Maybe you have the question about this pace or this step of action planning that we are going to have in the next 6 days starting from today. Come on, anyone would like to ask the questions, please? Come on. Okay, first Miss Ila Halila, come on, what is it, Miss?
Yes.
Ila Halila.
Yes, mister. I've noted many things about your explanation, and I'm curious about the, what is it, designing the plan, lesson plan for offline and online. So does it mean that we have to design two versions, both of them, online and also offline, or just choose one of it? Thank you, mister.
Okay, thank you for the question, Miss Ila Halila. We are going to have two action planning. We are going to plan two action, right? So what was that? So to make it more clear, so you're going to have a various kind of experience If you choose to make it an online for the first action planning for the two meeting, that should be okay. And then for the second action planning, if you're going to choose it here in an offline one, yeah, so that should be okay. So we're gonna have both. The first, it will be in an online one, and then second one, it will be an offline one. Or the other side, you may try to combine it. That's the expectation of you guys when you try to make the action planning. Because when you are going to have the teaching practice, of course it will be based on the situation, based on the condition of your guys' school. If your guys' school here already got the offline meeting, so you're gonna create the offline meeting. If it is still using an online meeting, so you're gonna teach an online class for your students. I hope that should be clear, Miss Ila Halila.
Very clear, thank you, Miss.
Okay, come on, anyone else, please? Anyone? Okay, come on, Miss Indri Puji. What is it? Do you question, Miss Indri?
Yes, sir, I have a question about the peer teaching. For the peer teaching, is it okay? Is it only one meeting only, or what, sir? For the peer teaching.
What is it? Can you repeat it? Sorry.
Okay. Is my voice clear?
Yeah. Now it's clear. What is it?
For the peer teaching, is it only one meeting, sir? For the peer teaching that
okay.
We record.
Okay, yep, of course it is only one, I guess, yeah, for your peer teaching, and then you may choose it from all of the learning design that you already created, yeah, so which one that you're gonna use. Okay, Miss Indri Puji?
Okay, sir, thank you, sir.
Okay, come on, anyone else?
May I add Miss Indri's question, Mr. Sofyan?
Okay, come on. Add
about,
it, please. What is it?
Yes, about the peer teaching. The durations of the video that we have to upload in our YouTube. So how many? How length is it?
Okay. I guess you guys can sit on the... wait a second. On the peer teaching. Okay, I'm gonna open it. It is consists of... 40 to 50 minutes, yeah, recording video of your guys practice and teaching, yeah, in the process of your teaching. 40 to 50.
Thank you, Mr.
Yeah, okay, come on. Anyone else?
Promise, sir.
Okay, come on.
Do we have to edit the peer teaching video until 15 or 10 minutes, like what you mentioned before?
I'm not mentioning 10 minutes. You're going to make a peer teaching video. The teaching practice here, the recording consists of 40 till 50 minutes. Yeah, it is not 10 minutes.
That's what I mean also.
No
fool, yeah.
No, you don't have to do an editing process, yeah, because you already plan, you already prepare your peer teaching since day one. Yeah, I already told you guys, okay, you have this, what is it, this short, yeah, short durations to conduct the peer teaching, and then also to arrange the schedule with all your guys' fellow teachers. That's why I hope you're gonna make it as soon as possible. Okay, Miss April. Yeah, so it is not 10 minutes. You're going to make it 40 to 50 minutes. Yeah, that's too short making a peer teaching video
no, because,
over 10 minutes.
No, because I don't know if I still remember or it's just my imagination. Before, there is a video that should be edited for 10 or 15 minutes, but in the important part, like pendahuluan, pembukaan, pendahuluan, and penutup, like that. So that's what I remember from the orientation.
Okay, from the orientation, I'm the one that giving you explanation, right? Hello, Miss April?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And then I can't recall it. I mentioned you're going to edit the video 10 minutes. Yeah, that's the fact. That's what I explained, I guess. A recording video of your guys' teaching practice consists of 40 to 50 minutes. Yeah? Okay, can you see the screen here? Hello, everyone?
Yes.
So it is not 10 minutes, yeah, you're going to have it 40 to 50 minutes. So you can make two games, yeah, the opening game or three games, that should be fine. The opening of the peer teaching, it should be 5 minutes game, and then in the middle 5 minutes game, and then in the end also 5 minutes game. So the games consists of 15 minutes. The rest of it consists of the opening and then also the delivering the content and then also the evaluation that you're going to make. I guess that should be that. Yeah? Is that clear?
Clear. And
yes,
we can,
sir.
And we can decide whether it is online or offline, right, sir?
Mm-hmm.
And we can decide it.
Yeah, you can decide it. That's why I told you, you're going to make two action planning. Yeah, the first, it will be online or offline, and then the second, it's up to you. Yeah, online or offline, as long as it is consists of two types of learning. Yeah, online one and then also an offline one. And then for your peer teaching, based on the PowerPoint, you may use it. Yeah, it is an online or an offline one. Okay, come on. What else? Anyone else? All set and clear? What happened with your face, Miss April? It's 40, 50 minutes. That what you're thinking? Come
he
on.
Wants to make 90 minutes, sir.
Huh?
He wants to make a 90 minutes.
Okay, 90 minutes. Okay, come on. Anyone else? Do you guys have any questions? No? If no questions, we're gonna go with the first session with Miss Rusmi. Miss Rusmi gonna enlighten you guys here with the overview of K-13 curriculum, with the lesson plan in K-13 curriculum, and then also the learning material in K-13 curriculum, learning media, and then after that one, the student worksheet, and then last one, the assessment instrument. Yeah. Okay, I guess no more questions, Mrs. Hildas. Why are you smiling? You guys 40 till 50 minutes, that's too short. You want it 1 hour maybe, or what is it?
I don't know, I just, it's funny.
It's funny.
I think it's orientation, I think.
Yeah.
Sir,
okay.
Hello, Mr. Sofyan.
Yeah.
Excuse me, I just moved to another room. First one, 5 to 2 minutes.
Okay, that's okay. That's okay, Mr. Smith. Yeah, we're going to wait for you. Okay, so since you guys already got your solutions, yeah, how that you're going to make the solutions into the lesson plan? There will be, what is it? There will be significant difference, I guess, with this goal that using a freedom to learn curriculum, yeah. The school that's still using a freedom to learn curriculum, you're going to make only one module of it as the learning tools or the learning design. While for the K-13 curriculum, you're going to make 5 sets of the document that you're going to use. Yeah, starting with the first here, this is the lesson plan. Yeah, second one, learning material. The third one, learning media. The fourth one here, the student worksheet. And then last one, it is the assessment instrument. Okay, fine. But for the freedom to learn curriculum, it is one only. But one consists of many things, yeah, in a learning module. Okay, come on. Before we are going to have the explanation from Miss Rusmi, I'd like to ask how many school here that using a freedom to learn curriculum? Hello? Miss Ila, you're using freedom to learn curriculum. One. Miss Febi, you're using really? And then Miss Indri, I guess it is you are still using, what is it? K-13 or freedom to learn curriculum?
I'm still using K-13, sir.
Okay, K-13, Mr. Hildas?
still K-13, sir.
Okay, Miss April? Miss April?
Freedom curriculum, sir.
Okay, nice one. So you get a freedom. Yeah, freedom with you, not a five single details like the rest, yeah? And what about Miss Dwidiana Sari? What is it that you use for your school?
Curriculum 13, mister.
Okay. Miss Helena, what is it that you use?
P13, sir.
Okay. Miss Endang?
Yes, sir. K13, sir.
Okay, K13. Miss Desmi?
For the first grade, freedom curriculum. Second and third grade, key curriculum.
Okay, so I'm gonna assume that you're going to use freedom to learn curriculum, yeah?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, next one, Mr. Five Fabry, what about yours?
K-13.
Okay, next, Mr. B, it is freedom to learn.
Because I am teaching in 12th grade, we are still using the K-13, sir. Because
okay.
The freedom for the 10th grade.
Okay. So majority of you guys, Miss Kartika, are you using the freedom to learn or it is K-13?
Freedom curriculum, sir.
Okay, thank you. So we have Miss Ila, Miss Kartika, Miss Desmi, and then also Miss April. Yeah, you guys are gonna make the learning module, yeah? And then the rest of you, Mr. B, Miss Febi, Miss Fine Febri, Miss Sandang, Miss Indri, Miss Erlina, Miss Studio, sorry, Mr. Hildas, you guys gonna make the, what is it? A set consists of 5 document of it. Yeah, consists of the lesson plan till the last one with the assessment instrument that you're going to use. Okay, is that clear? Anyone else would like to ask the question? Please. Come on, anyone?
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Actually, the last. Maybe last two years ago, we use a new model like a piece of RPP, RPP selembar, isn't it? So, which one is okay for us to design? Such an RPP like.
Okay, for the lesson plan, it will be based on what is it the lesson plan that you use for the K-13 curriculum. If it is only a single page of lesson plan, that should be okay. If that what you use for the K-13 curriculum, yeah. If it is consists of many kind of pages for your lesson plan, that should be okay. If it is the lesson plan that you use for the K-13 curriculum, and then we are going to have the the explanations after this one from Ms. Rusmi. Yeah, what kind of the lesson plan, what kind of the details for all of the learning document that you guys have to prepare. Yeah? Okay, Mr. Hildes?
Yeah. Okay.
Come on, anyone else? While waiting for Ms. Rusmi? Anyone?
Once more, sir.
Okay, what is it?
Actually, for me, I'm not sure is our lesson plan relevant with is it the right lesson plan or no? I think we have to discuss about this. There is no correction for my lesson plan before at school. Is it okay for the right lesson plan? Should we use for our learning, like that?
Okay, I guess for the lesson plan, especially for the K-13 curriculum, we are going to discuss it more with Ms. Rusby after this one. Okay, Mr. Hildas?
Okay. Thanks.
Okay, I guess Ms. Rusmi already joining, and then time is yours, please, Ms. Rusmi, to enlighten all of our participants here about the element in K-13 curriculum, and then also the lesson plan in K-13 curriculum, the Taiwan learning material in K-13 curriculum, learning media, student worksheet, and then assessment instrument in K-13 curriculum. Okay, Miss Rusmi, time is yours, Miss.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Sofyan and Bapak Ibu. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Is it clear, Bapak Ibu? Is it clear,
yes,
my voice?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Because I move on my class, I must enter in the classroom because I can sit on the behind of counseling room. Tadi saya sudah mencoba ya bersembunyi supaya lebih jelas, tapi harus masuk kelas ya. Okay, thank you, Bapak Ibu. I think in this activity you will get an exploration related with explanation and suggestion designing on the first innovative learning based on the result of identification of the lesson plan. Ya, Bapak Ibu ya. Berdasarkan ini, kalau saya menyimpulkan, Bapak Ibu, maybe based on the result of the identification of the lesson, of the lesson plan, and then root analysis of learning, and syllabus, yeah, analysis of syllabus. I really hope you already know the step of creative and fun innovative learning. Am I right, Bapak Ibu? Saya berharap Bapak Ibu sudah sangat sudah tidak asing lagi ya dengan langkah-langkah pembelajaran yang kreatif dan inovatif, karena on the first we must to know about the step of creative and fun innovative learning. Step-stepnya harus jelas ya Bapak Ibu, harus kita kuasai dulu. Seperti yang diminta di sini, we use about PBL and PGBL. I think as a teacher, we must know about the step of creative and fun learning. But in that is wrong step, that it's not suitable about the use of the learning method. Bapak Ibu, for RPP, yeah, for RPP according the class you teach, I think this is four kind that's currently in curriculum. Yeah, I think we have about the step of 13 step. Yeah, Bapak Ibu ya, di curriculum 13 dulu Bapak Ibu. Secara keseluruhan format RPP itu ada 13 ya Bapak Ibu ya. Ada 13. Why I ask this? Because I know there are about many design of lesson plan, ya. Bahkan yang very simple satu lembar itu sebenarnya tidak sesuai ya Pak Ibu. That is not suitable. Memang kita di yang namanya merdeka ya independent, but I think if one paper, just only one piece that is not related with our media. I ask make note. Saya sedikit buat catatan Bapak Ibu. Hanya sharing saja Bapak Ibu, sharing dengan RPP yang Bapak Ibu buat, karena as a teacher I think you has know about the good of lesson plan ya. Jadi format-format yang sesuai, karena setiap semester Bapak Ibu sudah pasti sudah supervisi kelas ya Bapak Ibu ya, from principal, vice principal and senior teacher. On my note I said about maybe if we are about there are one seat and maybe there are five seat and there are many models, bahkan ada yang dijual bebas ya Bapak Ibu ya, format RPP itu yang dalam bentuk CD-CD ya, ada yang dijual bebas di situ yang terkenal dengan cap tembak atau cap tangan ya, RPP cap tangan Ibu masih ingat itu dulu ya, pertama booming K-13 ya, kurikulum itu di mana-mana sampai tidak dihapus, hanya kopas-kopas akhirnya yang muncul RPP cap tembak atau cap tangan. Masih ingat Pak Biso, ada tembakannya begini ya. Nah, itu berarti itu beli gitu. Saya masih ingat. Kalau RPP itu masih seperti itu, berarti hanya copy paste, just copy paste from the resource of the CD. Because there are many I think about many model, saya Bapak Ibu ya, banyak sekali model-model RPP yang tidak benar sebenarnya. Tapi karena that is to make lazy ya, pekerjaan guru kan banyak, tidak mau membuat file atau dokumen, jadi beli saja. Nah seperti itu juga that is not good because as a teacher we have prepared about this lesson plan before. And then would be nice to use RPP according to the correct concept ya, Bapak Ibu. I hope you would be nice to use RPP so correct concept. Kita pakai konsep yang benar ya, Bu. Bapak Ibu, format pertama mungkin Bapak Ibu masih ingat ya, di Permendikbud ya, Permendikbud number 22 of 2016, we are concerning standard for primary and secondary education process. Ya, Bapak Ibu, di situ ada permennya. Number one, RPP itu komponennya yang pertama harus mencantumkan identitas sekolah ya Bapak Ibu, school identity. School identity, namely the name of the education unit like SMPN 85, SMPN 37, etc. And the second, identity of subject ya Bapak Ibu ya. What is mean identity of subject? Like identitas mata pelajaran ya Bapak Ibu, jangan lupa. Don't forget about identity of subject like English, ya, English, science, etc. And then the third, class or semester, jangan lupa Bapak Ibu cantumkan. Saya rangkum ada 13 ya Bu. The third is class or semester and for about subject matter ya, subject matter Bapak Ibu. Yang keempat ini materi pokok, jangan lupa ya Bapak Ibu, the subject or the matter. And then number five, time allocation, don't forget ya, time allocation, waktu ya Bapak Ibu ya, alokasi waktu. And then the six, we use about learning object Bapak Ibu ya, learning object, or we use about tujuan pembelajaran ya, learning object, alurnya seperti itu Bapak Ibu, learning object. And then about this is of and the last is basic competence ya. After learning object, the seven is competencies and indicators of competency achievement ya Bapak Ibu ya. Jadi kita nanti setelah menentukan tujuan pembelajaran, maka langkah ketujuh adalah write about kompetensi dasar dan indikator pencapaian yang harus kita tuliskan untuk pembuatan RPP ini. And number eight, learning materials, Bapak Ibu ya, learning material. Nine, learning methods. Nanti ada metodenya dicantumkan ya, Bapak Ibu ya, learning methods. Ten, learning media, karena kita harus menggunakan media ajar ya, medianya apa saja. And then 12, step of learning ya, langkah-langkah pembelajarannya ya Bapak Ibu, seperti ya like maybe about opening etc. nanti dicantumkan. And then the 13, assessment of learning ya, assessment of learning outcome, so that in preparation of the independent curriculum RPP or lesson plan is there are things like maybe for independent curriculum that is different ya Bapak Ibu ya, that is very different karena nanti ada, kalau disingkatnya hanya ada tiga bagian, atau kalau saya mencatatnya lebih dari tiga ya Bapak Ibu, karena untuk independent curriculum itu hanya menggunakan yang pertama itu student profile ya Bapak Ibu ya, disebutkan di situ yang sesuai dengan yang saya sebutkan, profil peserta didik dahulu ya Bapak Ibu ya. Jadi di COP RPP-nya itu adalah we use about student profile, kemudian what we want to learning objective ya, learning objective, and then learning activities. Fourth, about evidence and assessment. And then number five about coverage ya Bapak Ibu. It mean coverage mean cakupan ya, cakupan materi ya, cakupan materi yang akan kita ajar. And then the last is about kegiatan pembelajaran or we say learning activities. Is it clear Bapak Ibu? I just want to say about komponennya dulu ya Bapak Ibu ya, komponen RPP. Why this, I say this is about komponen RPP because you will make about the lesson plan ya. Yeah. Jadi kalau I hope because you have on PPB PPG Daljab. You must know about the true of komponen RPP. Ya Bapak Ibu, komponen RPP-nya mohon, karena kadang-kadang ada yang menulis dengan huruf ya Bapak Ibu ya, dengan huruf ABCD gitu ya. ABCD sampai G ya Bapak Ibu ya. Sampai H kalau enggak salah sampai I gitu. Komponennya jangan ditukar-tukar ya Bapak Ibu ya, ikutin saja mulai school identity dan sebagainya. Jadi in according to my so I make note, this is about 13 component of lesson plan from K-13 curriculum, and then from independent curriculum there are about 5 component ya. Yang pertama itu ada, sorry I say in bahasa, profil peserta didik ya, kalau salah dibenarkan ya Bapak Ibu ya, karena ini yang sudah saya ambil begitu ya, yang sudah saya dapatkan di pelatihan kurikulum merdeka. Jadi yang pertama profil peserta didik, kemudian tujuan pembelajaran, the third about the activity of a study atau kegiatan pembelajaran di kelas, the fourth or number four is bukti dan assessment ya Bapak Ibu harus ada, and then number five cakupan, dan keenam adalah kegiatan pembelajaran. So I think that is for independent curriculum is simple, yeah, simple than K-13. But this is about another insight in Indonesia, maybe, sorry, ATP ya Bapak-Ibu ya, ada CP, ATP ya, ada capaian pembelajaran, dan alur tujuan pembelajaran ya Bapak-Ibu. Nanti kalau I know that as a teacher, You has browsing. You has about maybe training about curriculum merdeka or independent curriculum. And when I say this wrong about component, you can ask or maybe comment. Or I think not. I just say about this is I make note about the component of curriculum. But if I wrong. Yeah, please make about suggestion or advice, or maybe you have about asking or have an idea that you have you had this material from independent curriculum. Bapak Ibu sudah semuanya sudah pernah ikut ya Bapak Ibu ya, sudah ikut training. Sorry, that it's used about pelatihan. Kurikulum Merdeka?
Belum, ma'am. Saya belum.
Oh, belum. Ada yang belum.
Miss Rusmi, pardon me, miss. I hope you're gonna focus on discussing about K-13 curriculum because
okay.
We divide it into two, yeah?
Okay,
you're the
okay.
One that taking in charge in K-13 curriculum, and then okay. I'll be the one that taking in charge in Freedom to Learn curriculum.
Okay, thank you, Miss Rusmi. Yeah, thank you, yeah. I own it. Okay. I just make differences about komponen of RPP ya, RPP of K-13 Bapak Ibu ya. Okay, Bapak Ibu, because that you make lesson plan that is related with your class you want to teach about this student, and I think for curriculum for K-13 ya, K-13 curriculum 13, I think that it's so make about in here on it's about learning objective ya Bapak Ibu ya. Okay, ya. Bapak Ibu, halo. We start from basic competence ya Bapak Ibu ya. Yeah. Basic competency and indicator of competency. Halo Bapak Ibu. Untuk nomor satu ya, from number one until number five. School identity, names of the, namely the name of the education unit, and then identification of subject or tema ya, atau subtema. Kemudian kelas atau semester, and then subject ya, subject atau meter, dan time location itu sampai ini untuk judul ya Bapak Ibu ya, sampai nomor 5 ya, sampai nomor 5. Nanti yang fokus Bapak Ibu di learning objective ya Bapak Ibu ya. Di learning objective, tujuan pembelajarannya ya Bapak Ibu ya. Di tujuan pembelajaran karena Bapak Ibu harus menentukan materi pokok ya, harus disesuaikan materi pokok dengan tujuan pembelajaran ya. Tujuan pembelajaran, kemudian kompetensi dasar dan indikator pencapaian Bapak Ibu ini disesuaikan dengan silabus, karena di dalam silabus itu ya, on the silabus there's only I think that's is only basic competent ya, basic competent and indikator kompetensi achievement Bapak Ibu ya. Yang nomor 7 ya Bapak Ibu ya. Untuk basic competent dan indikator of competency achievement ini harus disesuaikan dengan materi pokok yang akan Ibu ajarkan sesuai dengan tema ya. Tema kemudian kalau langkah-langkah pembelajaran Bapak Ibu sudah lebih detail lagi ya nanti ya di langkah-langkah pembelajaran, karena what we must do on the first step for example of opening ya, in opening you must make about maybe ice breaking ya. Di opening silakan Bapak Ibu harus ada ice breaking nanti ya. Ice breaking agar anak-anak lebih lebih fun sehingga pada saat memulai pelajaran Ibu siswanya tidak takut lebih dahulu ya. Tidak takut atau tidak apa namanya? Tidak hilang motivasinya. They don't have about motivation to study. Untuk metode mengajar saya rasa Bapak Ibu sudah sangat paham karena because you have teach about at least 5 years before PPK Daljab ya. Sudah hampir 5 tahun Bapak Ibu sudah sangat paham, and then I focus on just basic competent and indicator of competency achievement. Ya, itu ya Bapak Ibu ya. Saya fokus di sini saja. Let's we discuss about learning object. We discuss about basic competence. Basic competencies and indicators of competency achievement. Ya. Oke, Bapak Ibu. Any question? We focus on kompetensi dasar dan indikator pencapaian kompetensi pada K-13 kurikulum. Halo?
Oke, ma'am. Oke, ma'am. Ajarin, ma'am.
Oke, ma'am. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
What we will learn, yeah, what we will learn, maybe we should support kalau learning objects sudah paham ya Bapak Ibu ya, learning objects tujuan pembelajaran sudah ada di silabus ya Bapak Ibu ya. That is
Mr. Smee, pardon me to interrupt, Miss. Maybe you can share it with us here, one sample of the lesson plan that you created. The lesson plan that the K-13 curriculum, and then we can discuss it with all of the participants here. This is the form of the lesson plan in K-13 curriculum. Yes. Okay. Lesson plan, and then also the learning media, and then the learning material, and then also the student worksheet, and then last one, assessment instrument, Mr. Smith.
Okay,
I
will open my document first. Wait a minute. This is for my lesson plan. May I share, sir? Hello.
Proceed, Mr. Smee. Come on.
Okay, I will share my. Okay. Is it clear, Bapak Ibu?
Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Yeah, it's me.
Your class 37.
Yeah, 37. I did at 37. This is about, I use about A, not one, ya, Papa Ibu, ya. Yeah. I ask about 13 because this is about school identification, ya, Papa Ibu. Ini di, nggak usah diperhatikan, Papa Ibu. Let the lab about this. Karena untuk ini semuanya sudah paham, ya, Papa Ibu, ya. Ini tidak ada namanya apa. Papa Ibu sudah, apa, is it close? Halo Bapak Ibu. Apakah sudah terlihat?
Yes,
is it clear?
Yes, it's clear, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. I say on this is of yeah, competence, ya, Bapak Ibu, ya, yang berbentuk dalam ini. Kenapa? Silakan Bapak Ibu. Indikator pencapaian tadi, ya, Bapak Ibu, ya. This is about indicator of competence and then we use about materi ajar, ya. Materinya, ya, Bapak Ibu, ya, tetap dicantumkan materi ajarnya. I say about prayer, ya. Yeah. This is prayer and then berbagi hal, we share another that interest with student and teacher, maybe about the process of learning, and then maybe we ask about another, because this is just opening, ya, karena baru pembukaan, Ibu sampaikan di sini, that is related your own, because that is about material of the subject. Jadi saya mau meneruskan untuk strukturnya di sini, ya, Bapak Ibu. Ungkapan hafalan tidak perlu dijelaskan tata bahasanya, karena ini memang untuk tata bahasa yang lebih detail nanti kita akan menggunakan RPP berikutnya, seperti itu. And this is, I write about completely, unsur kebahasaan juga harus lengkap, Bapak-Ibu, walaupun kalau kosakata ini boleh lebih, ya, Bapak-Ibu, ya. This is just only I write about this unsur kebahasaan. If you will write about a complete of this material, it's okay. Yeah. That is according with this teacher. Model pembelajaran, Bapak-Ibu, harus tetap ada, ya, model. And this is about this activity. Kegiatan pembelajaran, I make about two meeting, ya. Untuk jam pembelajaran, ya, 2 jam pembelajaran. Ada pertemuan pertama, saya ngambil di sini, ya, lokasi waktunya. Yeah. I prepare my student on physics and psychics to follow this process of study. And then I ask maybe some question about our material before, ya, Bapak Ibu, ya. Ini masih tetap kita sampaikan juga. So I will keep about, don't forget to make write about about the time, ya. Yeah. 10 menit, 7 menit sampai 10 menit, ya, maybe Bapak Ibu, 10 until 7 until 10 minutes, that's enough. Don't make about opening is more than 10 minutes, that is so very long. I think 10 minutes is enough. Yeah. And then what student do? What student do? I say, yes, I use a film. Ada sedikit dialog, ya, Bapak Ibu, ya. Menampilkan film dialog yang menyatakan congratulation. But this is not a film. I think this is about just video. Just video, the conversation of my dialogue of congratulation, because on the first, ya, I will scroll on the pop up ya. Yeah. Ini ya Bapak Ibu ya. Materi pokoknya di sini ya sesuai dengan silabus ya Bapak Ibu. Jangan di luar silabus ya. You just copy from syllabus ya. Yeah. This is just copy from syllabus. Ya, yeah. Teks lisan ya yeah, dan tulis yang transactional and interpersonal. Yes. Sebenarnya di in this English lesson on K13 we just say about transactional interpersonal, short message dan teks ya, yeah. Dan teks monolog. Tiga poin itu ya Bapak Ibu ya. Sebenarnya bahasa Inggris di kurikulum 13 hanya itu. I will ask one more, transactional interpersonal, kemudian short functional text dan teks monolog. Short functional text, you have to know about there are many short functional text that related with syllabus ya Bapak Ibu, related with syllabus and related with the level of we will to teach about English ya Bapak Ibu ya. Ini tinggal copy, jadi Bapak Ibu menyiapkan materi jangan di luar ini ya. If you will about make like video or maybe another source of learning, just see about materi pokok. Tetap harus kembali ke materi pokok. And then for competence, ya. Yeah. Untuk kompetensi inti ini, Bapak Ibu, I will ask one more. This is about for because K13 we use about spiritual and social ya. Ada nilai spiritual dan sosial ya Bapak Ibu. Jadi kita ke KL3 and KI4 ya. Kompetensi inti ya Bapak itu. KI3 and KI4. Ini ada yang KI3 ini tentang spiritual ya Bapak Ibu. Ada penilaian spiritual dan penilaian sosial ya. Sosialnya yang KI4 ya Bapak Ibu. Karena sesuai dengan rapor ya, according to the basis of e-report, we just fill in knowledge and practice ya, pengetahuan, keterampilan, kemudian we use about social and this is about untuk memahami, menerapkan pengetahuan faktual ini hampir sama ya Bapak Ibu ya, untuk bahasa Inggris itu. K3 dan K4 sama semua. Nanti Ibu juga tinggal mengcopy ya. Ini tinggal di-copy karena ini sudah ada di silabus yang paling atas ya Bapak Ibu ya. Untuk silabusnya nanti Bapak Ibu bisa membuka silabus Bapak Ibu. Kebetulan ini kelas 9 ya Bapak Ibu. Karena saya mengampu kelas 9, banyak kelas 9. Kelas 7 untuk freedom curriculum saya tetap dimasukkan. Tapi hanya dua kelas saya mengajar, jadi proyek saya lebih sedikit. Ini nanti tetap spiritual and sosial ya Bapak Ibu. Lihat sini Bapak Ibu, Pak Sofyan, untuk nilai spiritual dan sosial itu tetap dicantumkan di rapot, tetapi tidak. Ini sambil lalu ya Bapak Ibu ya. Nilai ini kan ongoing proses ya Bapak Ibu. Nilai KI3 dan KI4 itu ada penilaian ininya adalah penilaian ongoing proses. Bapak Ibu bisa melihatnya sambil pada saat mengajar karena di K13 ini kita tidak punya waktu lagi untuk just focus on KI3 and KI4. Lihat sini Bapak Ibu indikator and then metode and this is about activity of study ya yeah, kegiatan pembelajaran. Yeah. Aksu dan mengamati Bapak Ibu. Masih sama ya. Peserta didik mengamati film dialog tentang congratulating. Ini kurang key ya, habit saya. And then ask the student, and then collecting information, Bapak Ibu. Ya, yeah. And then ini masuk kegiatan inti ya, Bapak Ibu. That is about main of activity, kegiatan inti, 60 minutes, that's enough. Because we have only 70 minutes. On 2 hours, ya. Yeah. Langkah-langkahnya ya, Bapak Ibu. Okay. And then I say open tutup or closing. This is closing, ya. Yeah. I make lesson plan for 2 meeting. Hello, Silen. This is for 2 meeting I make, ya. Yeah. So make simple. Karena kalau setiap pertemuan saya membuat menggunakan identity of school, this is very very busy, or maybe that is make a long time to make RPP. This is my RPP, Pak Sofyan, Bapak Ibu semua, until nah, dan this is until G. This is ya Bapak Ibu ya. Di penilaian pembelajaran cantumkan juga Bapak Ibu, this is about remedial and pengayaan upon the ketahuan, and this is about don't forget to give about instrumen penilaian Bapak Ibu ya. Instrumen penilaian that is very important because this is a guidance of to give the student point of their activity. Poinnya jelas ya Bapak Ibu, sangat sering menunjukkan sikap tanggung jawab. Nah, peduli kerjasama cinta damai. Nah, this is about social ya, yeah, this is about sosial ya, penilaian sosial Bapak Ibu. For penilaian observasi ada sikap ya, tertulis pengetahuan, kemudian unjuk kerja dan keterampilan Bapak Ibu. This is about practice of the student doing. The student will practice. I say about instrument penilaian, and then yeah, I use about our material. Yeah, boleh di ini ada. It's better you give about the sample of we make about student activity. Ya, Bapak Ibu, untuk mengukur kemampuan pengetahuan pada saat kita selesai menerangkan atau menjelaskan, biasanya sebut like post test, ya, like this. So I beg about the knowledge of point, ya, the score of pengetahuan, like this. Just I want just make about one number. Ini hanya saya berikan satu nomor karena another I use about on lampiran ya Bapak Ibu ya. Yang lain saya letakkan di lampiran karena masuk kepada kriteria dan skor. Terampilan tulis Bapak Ibu C2 and then I touch. Nah, jelas. Ini jelas ya Bapak Ibu ya. Medianya jangan lupa. Media dan alat Bapak Ibu. The source of this learning. I use media or alatnya screen, maybe laptop, komputer, LCD, etc. Whiteboard. Please write it. And then this is well, the subject of maybe you use about picture, slide, video, flashcard. And don't forget text script. And resources I use about buku paket bahasa Inggris kelas 9. Okay, and that's enough. Please ask if you will ask about maybe asking or maybe comment or an idea, Bapak Ibu. Halo.
Yes, ma'am.
Maybe, is it clear, Bapak Ibu?
Yeah, it's clear. Maybe the teachers from the second grade, we call it junior school, will give a comment about this.
Yeah.
Some of our friends.
Yeah.
And Rusmi.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, Bapak Ibu, silakan. Just, this is just sample, Bapak Ibu. You just make or you just create about the best one. Please create about the best one of lesson plan. But I would say about when I ask you to make about component of RPP, like this komponennya jangan lupa ya Bapak Ibu. Yeah. Don't forget to write kompetensi dasar. Yeah. Like, okay, please. Any other? Is it enough, Bapak Ibu?
Yes, ma'am. Mungkin
yes, Miss Ender.
Besok Erang kan mau ini juga, rencana mau yang Erang udah ambil yang kemarin itu kelas 9 semester 1 tentang congratulation-nya juga gitu kan. Jadi ini ada gambaran, berarti nanti Erang tinggal masukin PBL-nya gitu ya, Mem?
Iya, dimasukkan PBL. Ke PBL-nya. Saya tidak menggunakan PBL. From this lesson plan, it's better use about, bentar, saya coba scroll dulu.
Iya, Mem.
Di indikator sini ya, Bu, ya nanti ya di materi aja.
Oh, di materi pembelajaran.
Materi ajar, oh, kemudian di metodenya di, Bapak Ibu, di metode pembelajarannya ya.
Metode pembelajarannya.
Nanti di metode pembelajarannya ditambah, Bapak.
Oke, Mem.
This is about question and answer discussion.
Dan juga kegiatan pembelajarannya ya, Mem.
Ya, di kegiatan pembelajaran.
Oke, Mem. Thank you.
Anything that is about the main activity ya, Bapak Ibu ya. Untuk metode pembelajarannya, sorry, on PBL or PJBL we use on main activity, di kegiatan inti ya, Bapak Ibu ya. Karena di sini kan ada mengamati ya nanti.
Yes, Mem.
It's better
langkah-langkah PBL.
Oke, Mem. Follow the rule of learning method, ya. Yeah. Okay, follow the rule of learning method. Nanti disusun berdasarkan ini ya, Bapak Ibu ya. Maksudnya untuk kegiatan siswanya, apa yang akan dilakukan oleh siswa tersebut, Bapak Ibu menuliskan langkah-langkah sesuai dengan metode pembelajaran yang akan Bapak Ibu pergunakan. Contohnya kalau PJBL maka fokus kepada langkah-langkah pembelajaran PJBL atau PBL.
Okay,
ma'am. Ya, sinap ya, Bapak Ibu.
Yes, ma'am. Okay,
thank you very much, Miss Herlina. I will ask something before I close about my share.
Di mana sih, ma'am, where we have to shoot right? Ya, model pembelajaran kita itu. Soalnya di situ kan metode, ma'am. Lihat, nggak ada model pembelajarannya. Kalau di LPP itu kan saya lihat mem itu kan metode, kemudian model pembelajarannya itu di mananya kita tuliskan mem, atau cukup di langkah-langkahnya aja berdasarkan misalnya
yeah.
Oh ya, besok
nanti ditambahnya model pembelajarannya di ini Bu, di kegiatan pembelajaran.
Oke.
Di kegiatan pembelajaran apa yang akan dilakukan oleh peserta didik. Kalau saya menggunakan peserta didik mengamati film dialog ini masih masuk dalam apa namanya? Kemarin saya menggunakan TPR ya sebentar. Ini memang
TPR.
Iya.
Oke.
Seperti asking the student to give a response itu juga masuk PBL. Hanya tidak dicantumkan di sini, Bu.
Iya, berarti kan nggak mesti dicantumin ya? Atau gimana, Mbak? Mesti dicantumin.
Dicantumkannya di ini ya, di pandit. Media alat dicantumkannya di medianya.
Oke.
I'm so sorry, dicantumkannya di metode Bapak Ibu, metode pembelajaran. Di metodenya pembelajaran apa? Metode pembelajaran kan banyak ya Bapak Ibu ya.
Iya.
Apa menggunakan PBL or maybe PJBL. Kalau di PPG Daljab ini kan difokuskan kepada PJBL ya Bapak Ibu ya.
Iya.
Karena mengacu kepada freedom curriculum atau mendekati.
Oke.
Thank you ma'am. Yeah. You're welcome. Miss Kartika.
Mem Rusmi.
Oh iya, Miss Dwi.
Mem Rusmi, saya mau nanya itu kalau penggunaan kayak AIAVAR itu dalam lesson plan itu ditaruhnya di mana itu ya, Mem? Saya bingung dong. Masih di itu unmute, Mem.
Kalau di K13 itu diletakkan di metode pembelajaran yang kita gunakan.
Oke.
tulisnya di metode pembelajaran ya, Mem?
Iya, di metode.
Misalkan AR gitu ya, Mem, ya?
Di metode pembelajaran ini ya, Bu? Metode pembelajaran, ya, ya. Saya menggunakan
kita tulis
discussion. Disesuaikan dengan kelas Ibu, karena kalau untuk IR, VR, I think that is for freedom curriculum, Bu.
Iya, Mem, memang masih belum ngerti juga. Jadi
iya,
mau masukin ke lesson plan gitu, Mem.
Iya, masih bingung kita itu. Itu harusnya kalau K13 bagaimana?
Halo? What it mean, Bapak Ibu? Gimana, Bu?
Itu harus dicantumkan enggak, Mem? IRE segala macam itu. Kan K13 enggak ada ya, Mem, ya?
Dari Bapak Ibu ada tidak yang semuanya apakah K13. K13 tetap dicantumkan juga, Bu, ini metode pembelajaran. Saya ya, hanya menulisnya simpel saja di sini. Pembelajaran, ya. Metode pembelajaran saya, tanya-jawab, diskusi. Tanya-jawab dan diskusi. Tapi ini lebih tepatnya harus ditulis yang lengkap. Jangan ikutin ini.
Ya, Mem, berarti yang pilih lebih salah satu gitu kan, Mem, PBL ya, atau PGBL salah misalnya.
Iya, okay. Betul. Nanti okay. Ditulis more than one.
Thank you, Mem.
Oke, okay, you're welcome. Untuk formnya sebenarnya lebih simpel di ini ya, Bu. Untuk kalau sudah mulai freedom curriculum lebih simpel ya. Because that is I think for the step from the step of K13 it is to make apa ya, saya mengatakan rancu begitu ya Bapak Ibu ya, rancu karena memang kalau ditinggal ini masih ada gitu ya. Kalau kita tinggal fokus ke, kita akan fokus ke yang model PRPP yang baru, itu nggak mungkin seperti itu karena we have still about maybe from the 8 and 9 ya, 8 and 9 grade itu masih rata-rata menggunakan K13 kurikulum.
Ya, Mem, benar.
Sebentar Bu, untuk materi. Sorry. I think for this metode pembelajaran itu kalau di catatan saya digunakan untuk ini apa namanya? Digunakan untuk mewujudkan suasana pembelajaran dan proses pembelajaran yang sesuai dengan KD ya Bapak Ibu ya, dengan KD yang disesuaikan dengan karakteristik peserta didik. Jadi di situ metode pembelajaran, Bu, benar ditulisnya di metode pembelajaran karena di situ ada pengamatan ya, tadi saya hanya mencantumkan pengamatan, tanya jawab, kemudian diskusi dan penugasan di situ. Itu untuk metode pembelajarannya. Kemudian kalau media, if we say about media of learning, itu sepertinya ada contoh-contoh ya, contoh-contoh perlengkapan yang akan kita gunakan pada saat mengajar ya Bapak Ibu, like flashcard or maybe we use about
InFocus
ya. Ya, InFocus dan sebagainya. Kalau menulis, kalau sumber Ibu juga sudah tahu ya, sumber kan sudah jelas
sumber ya. Buku, ya.
Sumbernya dari mana? Sumbernya maybe from ya, bahkan link juga harus dicantumkan ya Bu, sebenarnya di situ link-nya dari mana ya. Ya, dicantumkan link sumber belajar yang Ibu ambil ya, karena itu kan resources from the learning media harus dicantumkan. And then this is about I think for the step of study ya, langkah-langkah pembelajaran, jangan lupa Bapak Ibu opening ya, openingnya pasti berdoa ya Bapak Ibu ya, berdoa, mengabsen jangan lupa. But if you will ask the student, if one by one just see about siapa yang tidak ada saja, jangan sampai
ya,
30 siswa ya, menghabiskan waktu gitu ya. And then don't forget to give tujuan pembelajaran or what related with KD ya Ibu, tujuan pembelajarannya disampaikan ya Bapak Ibu ya. Don't forget about we use about what we will learn this morning or this afternoon ya. Don't forget to ask the student of basic competence and indicator of competency achievement. Anak-anak, hari ini kita akan belajar tentang congratulate someone, what you
what you must about competency you will achievement ya. Sampaikan ya Bapak Ibu, apa yang harus kamu peroleh, apa yang harus kamu pelajari hari ini, seperti itu harus harus kita sampaikan, atau mungkin maybe you will share about screen ya, tetapi sampaikan Bapak Ibu, today we will study about and then what we get it of the result of the student when we are finished of study. Ya, disampaikan juga, diaplikasikan di lingkungan mereka ya Bapak Ibu. Try to use this learning media to our students, and then don't forget to keep remind or maybe a reminder to our student of about their activities after study ya, after study mereka harus mengaplikasikannya di luar ya Bapak Ibu. Any other question, Bapak Ibu? Miss Desmi, maybe? Learning materials, Bapak Ibu, learning materials?
Mem Rusmi, di Mem Rusmi.
Ya, halo.
Di tujuan pembelajaran itu harus melihat C1, C2, C3-nya kan ya, Mem ya. Seperti tujuan? Itu, C4. Tujuan pembelajaran, melihat C1, ya, C2.
Ya, ya, ke sana, Bu. Ini berarti tujuan pembelajaran. Sesuai dengan metode, gitu. Ya sesuai dengan metode pembelajaran yang Ibu akan gunakan. Ya, ya.
Penilaian sikap dilampirkan itu kan yang Mem, penilaian sikapnya ya?
Ya, penilaian sikapnya untuk penilaian sikap ini sebenarnya bukan hanya dilampirkan Bapak Ibu, you just input on e-report. Am I right? Kan harus muncul Bu di penilaian sikap ini, ya, sikap spiritual dan sosial di KI3 and KI4. KI4 yang untuk active of religion and PKN ya Bapak Ibu ya. Sorry, religion and PK ya and counseling. Ini harus mencantumkan semua karena when you make about pada saat setting KIKD di e-rapport, ini kan dicantumkan ya Bapak-Ibu, to make a plan of e-rapport. Ini KI3 and KI4, that's all of the subject. Ya, itu kan di situ banyak ya Bapak-Ibu ya. Berdoa, kemudian menghargai
teman sebaya, ya gitu.
Ya, menghargai apa teman yang sedang ibadah dan sebagainya. Itu kalau nggak salah kompetensi. Kalau yang spiritual itu ada 6 ya kalau nggak salah itu. Boleh dipilih semua, boleh diambil satu, minimal 3 bukan? Minimal 3 ya Bapak Ibu ya. Minimal 3. And then for sosial juga demikian ya Bapak Ibu ya, sosial. Untuk deskripsi ya. Deskripsi of social and spiritual itu Bapak Ibu tinggal klik saja nanti ya. Sudah sangat paham Bapak Ibu. Let's we see about on one more on metode Bapak Ibu, metode pembelajaran ini saya mencantumkan diskusi, tetapi ya because I think for the student activity Bapak Ibu ya, saya fokus on student activity Bapak Ibu. Ini ya Bu, mengamati ya Bapak Ibu ya, di mengamati ini sudah masuk sebenarnya, sudah masuk PCBL juga ya Bapak Ibu. Hanya tidak belum saya cantumkan di PCBL-nya, tapi langkah-langkahnya sudah masuk ke PCBL, yaitu mengamati, menanya, dan collecting information. Harus sesuai ya. Kalau dulu kan ada GCOT ya Bapak Ibu ya, tapi itu ada yang menggunakan, ada yang tidak ya. Join learning contraction, etc. Karena that is about many kind of RPP, and then I use about the better of on my mind, yeah. I think that is good for my student, and that is about to make easy document, yeah. Karena you must collect it, this lesson plan every semester, yeah. Every semester. That's enough, Bapak Ibu.
Hey, ma'am. Any question? Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, I will stop my share screen.
Tatina, Miss Rusmi.
Yes, sir. I just in remark of number 6 and 7 on learning object and basic competence, ya, Bapak Ibu, ya.
And then they are going to have more discussion about it.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, yeah. Okay, thank you, Mr. Sofyan, and all participants, Bapak Ibu. Yes, sir.
Okay, I mean, do you guys still gonna discuss it first, or it might turn to give them the material, learning material? Ms. Rusmi.
I think that is learning material.
Okay, it's my turn then, Ms. Rusmi.
Okay, yeah, that is turn for Mr. Sofyan. I will continue after, maybe from Bapak Ibu will ask about on special for K-13 curriculum. Ya, Bapak Ibu, ya, nanti kalau ada pertanyaan lagi silakan. I think this is for recap. It's time for Mr. Sofyan.
Okay, I'll try to explain only 10 minutes. 9:30, yeah, 9:30. It will be a chance for you guys to do a Q&A with Mr. Rusmi. Yeah, I'm gonna share.
Okay,
yeah, okay, I'm gonna share what will be the set of learning document, a complete one. And then it is from the last year PPG Daljab that we have from our English department. Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna make it quick. Yeah, I hope you guys. Okay, can you guys see it? Hello?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Okay, only 10 minutes, and then after that one, you're going to discuss with Ms. Rusmi. Okay, guys, this will be the example of a complete set of the document for the learning that you're going to create based on those that implementing K-13 curriculum, yeah? And then in K-13 curriculum, I told you earlier, it is starting with the first, it will be lesson plan. Second one, the learning learning material. The third one, learning media. And then the fourth one here, it is the student worksheet. And the last one, assessment instruments. And then this will be the complete example from the last year PPG Daljab, yeah? Okay, now let's try to have a look at here the example. First of all, the lesson plan consists of, it is do when we do the teaching and learning here, it is consists of an offline and then also an online one. Yeah, so this will be the example of the lesson plan that you guys can use. And then this one here related with K-13 curriculum. Yeah, you can make it like this one, a simple kind of lesson plan, I guess. Yeah, you can mention about the name of the school, the class, and then the duration of the lessons, yeah, what kind of subject, your guys learning material of it. Yeah, and then the basic competent here, and then next one here, the learning, the aim of the learning, and then step in learning. The first detail here is the lesson plan. Okay, everyone. Yeah, we can have a look at here the step in the process of the learning activities, starting with the opening 10 minutes, and then main activity 70 minutes, yeah, and then last one here is the closing 10 minutes. The difference with you guys here, you have to consider about the integrating a problem-based or project-based, yeah, project-based learning. And then it should be about the artificial intelligence or augmented reality or virtual reality. If you guys can master that one, and then if you can deliver that to the classroom, yeah. And then that was the example, a simple one. And the next year closing, last one, it will be the learning assessments. Yeah, this will be the learning assessment. And then it will be approved by the principal of yours, and then you are as the English teacher. Yeah, this will be the example of a simple lesson plan that you can use as the first, yeah, as the first set of the document. And then second one, about the learning media, we can have a look at here the learning media. It is a simple fast 10, and then here the example, it is watching the video using the video. L using the video, and then we have the vocabulary builder here, several kind of the list of vocabulary, yeah, and then also we have the pronunciation practice, yeah, performance visit till the last one, and then next here is also more explanations, yeah, this is the media that used by the teacher, yeah, and then we have also the grammar review, yeah. And then we have the past verb also, yeah. And then we have this, the crossword puzzle. This is the most important element in making a learning set, one set of learning document here. It should be a fun one. It should be an innovative. We have the game here. We have the crossword puzzle of it, yeah. And then we can see the identifications, yeah. Okay, and then we have also the video. We have more video explaining about the topic that we discuss for the students, and then we have the role play things, yeah, this is a fun kind of learning, yeah, and it's the homework for the students, yeah, and the next one here is the learning material. This is the third one, yeah, the learning material that provided by the teacher here. We can see starting with the table of content, simple past and background of knowledge, definition, formula, and then grammar review. That was the list of the all the learning material, starting with the simple past tense, what is it, the learning aim, the background of knowledge, which the video, this the use of the video, yeah, and then the vocabulary building, yeah, the formula, the grammar review of it, and then blah blah blah, yeah, and then don't forget to put the reference also. And the next one, it will be the student worksheet. This is the example of the student worksheet that you guys can create it here for the simple past tense thing, yeah? Okay, we can have a look at here the identity of the school, basic competence, what is it, the topic that you're going to discuss, the learning aims of it, yeah? This will be the form of the student worksheet, yeah? So, consists of the student identity, class group, and then also the group participant. We can have a look at here. They are working their student works with in a fun way. Yeah, they're trying to find what is the regular verb, what is it the irregular verb of it. Yeah, that will be the example of the student works with. And we have the task 2 here, task 3. Right. Yeah. Okay, that will be the example of the student works in LKVD. And then last one, the assessment instruments. The assessment instrument here, you can see it, guys, starting with the instrument one, yeah, instrument one with all the details of it, yeah, and then what kind of the talks, what kind of the question that you use here, yeah, and then we have to provide also the answer key of the question that we deliver with, that we give to the student, and then this will be the scoring rubric for it, yeah, okay. Okay, and then this will be the rubric for the scoring of writing product, yeah, and speaking, yeah, and then how that we the morality of the student from observing, yeah, all element that we try to observe, yeah. That was the example of a complete 5-set of document, starting with the lesson plan as the first, yeah. You guys can see it. Let me repeat it one more time, yeah. A complete set consists, the first here it is lesson plan, and then second one after the lesson plan it is the learning media, yeah, and then after the learning media we have the next here it is the it is the learning material, all the content that we deliver to the students, yeah, and then after that one we have the student worksheets, yeah, this is the student worksheet or LKVD that we deliver to the students, yeah, and the last one it will be the assessment instrument, what kind of instrument that we use to assess the teaching and learning process, yeah. Okay, I guess that's all 10 minutes for me, Miss Rosmi, and the rest of you guys, a complete example starting from lesson plan till the last one, the form of set of document that you guys can imitate, that you guys can use to design your innovative learning for the student. Thank you very much, Miss Rosmi, and then go back to you. Please try to guide them for the discussion first, because I have to during the thesis defense. Yeah, I'm gonna do the thesis defense for my students. Okay, thank you. Come on, go back to you, Ms. Rusmi.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Sofyan. Bapak Ibu, that is so very completely about curriculum Merdeka, independent curriculum.
Sorry, it is not the independent curriculum, Miss. It is based on K-13, an additional from me. Yeah.
Oh, additional.
Yeah.
Because that is freedom, sir. Freedom means make not like so very. That is about make a simple design, ya, Bapak Ibu. And then. Bapak Ibu, sorry, I say in bahasa, how it's better. Hello.
Hello,
Bapak Ibu.
Ma'am, nggak apa-apa, ma'am, in bahasa aja.
Biar in bahasa aja, ma'am.
Lebih